Let us consider dehydrohalogenation. By E2 mechanism, what will be the product for this reaction? So the question is, if I have this molecule, and we do dehydrohalogenation, we will get an alkene. So basically, there are two geometrical isomers are possible for product. So we can have cis isomer or we can have trans isomer. So question is, either cis isomer will be obtained as product or trans isomer will be obtained as product, or cis as well as trans both will be obtained as a product. This can be answered only while looking the mechanism of E2 reaction. Basically, E2 mechanism is one step mechanism. So base subtract a proton, at the same time leaving group departs the molecule. And we have a alkene formed. This mechanism has antiperiplanar transition state. So let us consider the given molecule. When I say antiperiplanar transition state, this means hydrogen and chlorine should be opposite in the transition state. So we can rotate about this single bond so let us rotate by 180 degrees. Methyl will go down the plane and phenyl will be up the plane. So this is the conformation after rotation about 180 degree along this carbon-carbon bond. So this is basically anti-conformation. Hydrogen and chlorine are anti to each other. Hydrogen and chlorine atom are anti to each other. Now base will abstract this proton and we will have carbon-carbon double bond formation. We can show transition state. So carbon hydrogen bond is broken. Base hydrogen bond is formed. Carbon carbon will have a double bond character and carbon chlorine bond is broken. So this is the transition state. And this time transition state is anti-periplanar transition state. So this is anti-periplanar. Now finally, we will have alkene formed. So this carbon becomes sp2 hybridized. This also becomes sp2 hybridized. So molecule becomes planar. So this pH group, this methyl group will go slightly up. And this pH and methyl group will go slightly down. And finally we will have all atom or all groups are in the same plane. So downside we have methyl, we have pH upside, and here we have pH downside, methyl upside. So this time we are getting trans product. Now if I ask, so if I do dehydrohalogenation by E2 mechanism, what will be the product? So base will abstract proton, we will have carbon-carbon double bond formation and chlorine will depart. This time we have anti-conformation. So there is no need to rotate a long carbon-carbon single bond. We can also show the transition state. So carbon chlorine bond is broken. Carbon carbon will have double bond character. Carbon hydrogen bond is broken. And base hydrogen bond is slightly formed. Methyl is downside the plane and ethyl is upside the plane, and on this carbon methyl is upside, ethyl is downside. So this is the transition state. Finally, we lose hydrogen and chlorine. Both carbon becomes sp2 hybridized and we have a carbon-carbon double bond. This group goes up, this also goes up, this comes down and this comes down. So we will have methyl, ethyl, ethyl and methyl. So this time we will have trans product. So we can derive products by writing NT transition state. So one important point in case of E2 elimination, we have NT transition state, NT periplanar transition state.